Hear me.
Doubt. Destroy. Contemplate. Fall silent. Build. Listen at last to what has always existed and was never there, and seek until your last breath the impossible pathway. Look for me. I'll show you how. I'll show you why. Follow my voice. What has never been, that which aches your entrails, is now tearing the earth, cracking the pavement, and spreading its roots, like shadows, over everything there is, but nobody wants to acknowledge. Not unlike the harsh woods, it rips apart the eyes of those who dare to look at it, and shows more paths than you could ever walk. This is its definition. An unfathomable threat, and nevertheless, a freedom of will brought to you, who struggle to be but art. Everything you see, all the angst you feel has always been there. It's been, along with you and all of us, hidden from our senses as an incomprehensible event, nonetheless bound into our skin.
Thank you.
time ago, when humankind wasn't even the spark of what it was to become, the universe ruthlessly took the human being by the neck, dragged them to an abyss, and cast them down, without any warning, amidst fire, stone, and water. Their naked and convalescent bodies shook among sharp rocks, only sheltered by cold and mist. The sky arose magnificently above them, and with every abrupt thunder they became more aware of their fragile physique. Every gust of wind warned them that their bones could be reduced to ashes, if the sky decided so. Then, horrified by everything and by the nothingness, humans gazed upon what they'd be, what they weren't, and what they could never become. Unable to fathom everything there was, humanity began to name everything they feared. They mastered the sky, the earth, and the entire world. Still in fear, they tied up what nobody else was able to see. They put it in order and enclosed it inside a concept, regardless of its endless nature. And thanks to that, what threatened to crush them submitted to their ego and was reduced, without thinking about it, to language. And then, carried away by a candle glow, humans forgot that their footprints were, after all, no more than what a single raindrop is compared to the sea.
Thank you. Thank you.
Their denial dissolved the fable in everything else and twisted, in a dream, the land where they were born. This way, and not by other means, they created the known world and soothed their spirit facing the endless. However, after setting the course of everything there was, they also set their own and chose only one of many possibilities, as they had done with the world. And so, their vast ego was also reduced to mere language. Inhibited by their fear of death, they branded the fable into their skin. They took a firm chisel, held their breath, carved the harsh rock, and turned it into a sculpture among threads and webs, lacking a mouth and a face. They now eat when they are told to eat, and speak when they are told to speak.